But right now, it's time for the Startup CEO.
Hello, my name is Mark Essien. I'm the founder and CEO of Hotels.ng, which is an online hotel booking service. What we do is we make all the hotels that are in Nigeria available to be booked online. I'm a computer engineer by profession. I studied computer science and computer engineering in Germany with a focus on robotics. I left Germany 3 years ago after my master's to come back to Nigeria to found this company. The company is funded by myself as one of the partners, Jason Njoku from Iroko TV, Echo VC and Omidyar Network. Omidyar Network is the investment vehicle of eBay founder Pierre Omidyar. I worked in Calabar for close to a year, so I was on my own there gathering hotels and trying to make the business scale. So we're already quite successful in Calabar. And at that point, we needed more capital that would allow us to expand across the rest of the country. Jason Njoku, who had already founded a successful technology company in Lagos, Iroko TV, he now reached out with an offer to invest $70,000 in the business. After a little bit of negotiation, I accepted the offer, moved to Lagos, and from there we're able to scale the business across Nigeria. So from the initial 150 hotels that we had in Calabar, now we have got over 7,000 hotels across the rest of the country. When we started, the market was quite uncompetitive. We're the first people that came in and kind of opened up the industry for others. Since then, a few other people have joined in on the race. But because we're first, we are lucky enough that we are able to maintain the top position in the market. I think that over time, we're going to see more and more competitors come in. And that's all right. Whenever there is a good market, then a lot of people enter the market. So I think that personal branding is extremely important in all forms of business. It's possible sometimes to have a business that works without the person branding himself. But for those businesses that work, you'll find out that typically the people running the business do have a quite prominent brand within their particular industry. It may not be known by the average person on the street, but in the industry that they are in, they're usually quite respected and quite a well-known character, and that usually comes through actual branding effort that the person put into that. I would not have been able to take the business that I have now from where it started to where it is now without actually branding myself and making sure that I project the right image in the technology circles. A lot of the funding that I was able to receive for the business came through that effort. So I think that branding is always critical, and everybody needs to recognize how they are being perceived and how best they can influence that perception in a way that drives themselves forward and also the business. Technology is a key distribution channel for any business, particularly modern businesses. We have sold millions of dollars of hotel rooms without any marketing, simply by leveraging technology wisely. Anybody that has the knowledge, that has the expertise about how he can use technology to drive customers, can basically build up a quite large business in this day and age without needing to invest large amounts of capital. One of the key technology aspects that works well for that is social media. Social media is useful on both driving customers and for personal branding. So I'm very big on running, for example, a Twitter account or properly maintaining a Facebook account for myself. And that drives my personal brand, which I can then convert into driving the brand of the business. Social media as a customer acquisition tool generates for us thousands of dollars in revenue every single week. So just our Twitter account basically pays for the salaries of five, 10 people in the company already. So I think that one should not ignore social media or technology, both as methods for branding and for customer acquisition. So I would think that the most challenging thing for the business as it is actually comes from the hotel end. For a lot of the hotels, they are seeing, they are understanding online services for the very first time. We are introducing it to them for the first time. It means we have to not only find customers, but we have to make sure that when the customer goes to the hotel, he has a great experience. So we have to put extra effort. We have to do a lot of extra things to make sure that there is not a hitch in the customer at the point that the customer goes into the hotel. I know that in the West and in other more advanced economies, that's not the case. They can simply make a booking and depend on the hotel to fulfill its part. We do not depend on the hotel because we know that the hotels may not be familiar with the entire process yet. So we go the extra mile to make sure that no matter what happens, the customer gets in properly. That's definitely a challenge. I think that one of the things that we would want to do in future is also related to that. We would like to contribute to the hotel and help improve their service. So there are ways that we can, you know, do trainings for the receptionists. We can do trainings on how they can manage a hotel, teach hotel managers how to basically become successful with their hotels. Things like that, I think, will grow the ecosystem, both for us as an online agent and for the hotels themselves to increase their own occupancy. And of course, for the most important person of all, which is our customer. If the hotels are functioning well and we are functioning well, then the customers will tend to generally be happy. So I think that's one of the things that we would like to do sometime in the future. As regards the far future, when I would say that we have made it, in quotes, with Hotels.ng, it's probably when we are a pan-Africa brand, so we're in every single African country, and potentially we do an IPO, so we go on the public markets. So the three words that would be in my book of strategy are, number one, understand what you are doing. Like, really understand what you are doing. Number two, keep on experimenting. So whatever it is that is there, you have to keep on experimenting. You never know what the truth is. And number three, understand what it means to have a monopoly position and what drives you into that. So we'll talk about monopoly in particular. Okay, so thank you on the money for coming. You know, it was nice having you here. I really enjoyed the chat, you know, but I've got to get back to work now, you know, so see you guys soon.